Am I the a-hole for wanting cameras on my cat's litter boxes to make sure he is using the bathroom while I work, while my boyfriend is freaking out about and objecting? My cat has FLUTD disease. If you don't know what that is, it's a condition where the urethra can get blocked and cause him to be unable to pee. If left untreated, he could die within 24 to 48 hours, have renal failure, burst kidney, etc. It's very serious, and he has already been blocked twice now. There's a lot of triggers that I can't control that could cause this to happen, but I do the best I can. I work 12-hour shifts, and I'm gone even longer than that with driving time, so I can't be there to watch over his litter box usage. I need to catch these symptoms early so I can get him to the vet as soon as possible. My boyfriend is in and out, he works regular hours, and he doesn't/can't keep that great of an eye on him. So, thinking absolutely nothing of it, I bought two Nest cameras so I can put them in the vicinity of the litter boxes, one in my bedroom and one in the other area of the house. This way I can make sure he's peeing and his behavior while he pees, because it's very different when he's blocked vs when he's not. My boyfriend comes home, sees this setup and basically demands I take them down. I'm confused. I ask him why. He knows the struggle I've been through the past year with him, knows my cat means the world to me, knows I have to monitor him carefully. He says he refuses to be in a house where someone can live stream watch him at any point when he's home. I'm like, someone. It's just me, and the cameras are on the litter boxes. I joke to him that if he wants to masturbate and doesn't want to be on video, just go to the bathroom. Complete joke. And he freaked out. Says I need to have them down by today. It's not like I'm surveilling the place. Literally, they're just on the litter boxes, which show only two sections of the house. He doesn't care that they're only on the litter boxes. I plan on turning them off when I'm home, not because I care if I'm recorded, but because I can just monitor my cat myself. Some things to note: it is my house. I pay the mortgage and the bills. He has his own house. He lives with his parents. He stays over a lot. He doesn't have to be here when I'm not here, but wants to be, and I don't mind if he is or not. I didn't record him without his permission, just set everything up before telling him, because I didn't think he'd try to object at all. Not the a-hole. Had a cat with renal problems. I get it. Pretty much second what everyone else has said. What the hell is he up to, that a litter box can't be monitored? That's exactly what I'm saying. Posted this in /relationships with a different implication and people think I'm nuts, apparently. Not the a-hole and not crazy. If I were in your shoes, I'd take his key for fear he'd tamper with the cameras, and I'd miss important signs. Renal issues in cats are no joke, and his baseless fear and entitled demands about your house could cost you thousands in vet bills or even kill your cat. It would be one thing if he expressed surprise and had a discussion about his concerns, but immediately giving you an order/ultimatum is not cool. Yeah, because you asked if your boyfriend's cheating and then ignored everyone expressing their privacy/safety concerns with being around Nest cameras/cameras in general that have nothing to do with wanting to cheat, lol. You've also ignored everyone asking you why you would suspect cheating in the first place. Originally, I would say not an a-hole or everyone sucks here. Your boyfriend for his overreaction/making demands he can't really make, and you for consistently trying to ignore/downplay your boyfriend's concerns and maintaining a my way or the highway attitude in a situation that could've been handled better by both parties. If I were in your shoes, I would've given any of my guests a heads up that I've put up in cameras in my house, because I know that randomly seeing cameras where there weren't any before can be a really unsettling experience, regardless of whether the camera is recording or not. I would definitely given my significant other a heads up before installing, especially since one of them will be recording/picking up audio in a regularly used intimate space, which can really freak some people out. But honestly, in the end, I think you're the a-hole because your significant other's overreaction, while unnecessary/unfortunate, was also an opportunity to learn where he's coming from and come to a compromise or at least better understanding of his needs/values, privacy being one of them. Instead, you're over at r/relationships repeatedly yelling at everyone asking you to have a little more empathy, that it's your house, so you can do whatever the f you want. He's in no place to demand anything from you, and any issues he might have is an issue he can deal with on his own. Your original intentions might be good, but the way you're navigating this whole conflict screams a-hole to me. From Op's comments, it sounded like he walked in on her while she was installing the bedroom cameras and that there was no prior discussion about them going in there. It's quite reasonable for someone to be perturbed about that situation. It wouldn't necessarily be immediately clear to him that the recordings were only going to focus on the litter box, or whether other parts of the bedroom or audio would be recorded as well. If I walked in on a boyfriend doing this, and they said it's just for my cat, I'm not sure I would believe them, because the situation would be so jarring. As it happens, I own my own home, and my boyfriend is typically over here several nights a week. Well, pre-virus. I wouldn't do something like installing a bedroom camera without consulting him first, because it's common sense that that might upset someone, and I care about his comfort and well-being. If you actually value your romantic relationship, then taking the other person's comfort level seriously is a lot more important than whose name is on the deed or the lease. I want him to feel loved and welcome here, because I love him. Not the a-hole. It's your house, your cat, and for God's sake, the cameras are literally only trained on the litter boxes, not watching the whole house. What is he so defensive over that two cameras which aren't even watching him are so upsetting? What is he trying to hide? Frankly, if he doesn't like it, he can just stay in his own home. Period. Anyone that is worried about being on a security camera for sure has something to hide, especially in this case, and he wasn't even in the situation where he was the one being watched. It was for her cat, to make sure it doesn't die. So the fact that he was worried even about that sends a huge red flag. If you have nothing to hide, you have nothing to fear. Maybe he picked his nose or itched his butt. I talked about it elsewhere, but I'm incredibly paranoid about cameras in private locations. I freaked out when my BF mentioned he wanted some in his apartment. I'm not cheating and would never ever. I do nothing wrong in his place, but I'd break up with him if he did that. It just makes me incredibly anxious and panicky. I don't want to be recorded when I'm naked or relaxing or eating, etc. I know I have specific issues when it comes to being filmed, especially unknown, but there's 100 reasons to freak out that don't include cheating or stealing or whatever. Girl, but there are security cameras almost everywhere, like every single store and popular storefronts. I mean, just in your situation with the security cameras your boyfriend wants, like that's just a better safe than sorry situation. What if someone breaks into his place? I know it can be uncomfortable at times, but in reality, it's not ever going to be seen, except in those extreme cases. That's why I specified private places. So pretty much apartments. I told him I'd be okay if it was pointed at the front door and back door, but he wanted one down the hallway. I walk there naked nearly daily. I'm not okay with that. TMI, but we've had sex in the hallway. I'm very not okay with that. I think the best solution is to share the link to the feed with him, so he can feel comfortable it's only pointed directly at the litter box. Having a camera in your bedroom, especially when you don't tell your partner, is actually pretty sketchy and crummy. I understand why. I love my dog more than anything, and I'd die in a heartbeat for my boyfriend's dog. But I won't sacrifice my comfort at home, even if it is Op's apartment. He spends significant time there for a relationship. I posted this elsewhere, but when I was in 4th grade, a janitor put cameras in the bathroom. I hadn't experienced assault or sexual harassment at this point and it hit me hard. I don't deal with things well. For years I felt uncomfortable in bathrooms and even changed under my sheets. I've also had a guy threaten to blackmail me with nudes, despite my face not being in them, when I ended things. I guess I'm pretty paranoid, and maybe that's not the norm. But the odds of a break in are not worth it to me. My boyfriend already has a gun, and is trained in these situations, and his neighborhood is safe. It just gives me the heebie-jeebies for someone to see me when I'm at my most vulnerable. Sorry for the rant. I guess this thread has been a bit of therapy for me. As a woman, I would 100% freak out if a boyfriend installed cameras in the bedroom without any kind of prior discussion with me, regardless of who owned the house or how many nights a week I stayed there. If I walked in on him installing them, it would be jarring, and I don't know that I'd be able to trust his word that he hadn't been recording me previously or capturing any private sounds/images, even if he had an otherwise plausible sounding reason about a pet. I do think, if the genders were flipped in this scenario, people would find that aspect far more alarming. And a guy who did this and said, "What's the big deal? It's my house," would come in for a lot more criticism for not understanding why his girlfriend might be perturbed and uncomfortable. Not an a-hole. At least not right now. You're not the a-hole for wanting to watch your pet as best you can in your own home to look out for a very real health concern. Completely get that. But I can also understand the very real weirdness of coming over one day to, "Hey, so, there's cameras in my house now." I could see how it might be a bit unsettling at first blush. You might start to wonder if there were additional cameras you weren't mentioning. Is every intimate word we say to each other now getting recorded? Are private times, intentionally or not, getting recorded, etc.? It's the kind of thing, even with the most innocent of intentions, like this, on your side, from the other perspective, would reasonably open up a lot of concerns. I would talk about it, show him the full setup and let him see the feed/angles, and have a good discussion about reasonable boundaries, like shutting off the cameras entirely when you're home and together, and how to prove that it's done, like giving him access to the feed/website when he's there, which would be off when you're home anyway, right, etc. Not the a-hole, because it's your house, not shared. I can see his side of it. I personally hate home cameras. They make me super on edge, though I'm doing nothing wrong. I don't think he's crazy for not being comfortable with them, though this certainly depends on how much of the rooms they see, but he is the asshole for trying to force you to get rid of them. They are being used for a medical purpose. For your cat, in your home, it's not his choice. Thanks for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe for more videos. See you all later.